at the end of the book were meant for my editorial comment. So even as a kid, there are these scribbles in there about my review of the book. Anyway, we know they're not usually supposed to be writing in the books. A Montreal teacher has come up with a book that brings all of these things together. Nancy Snipper is the author of the Crazy and Amazing Five Senses book. It has school boards recommending it, and it's available in English and French. And she came into studio a little earlier today to talk with me about it. Hi, thanks for coming in.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
Now, how would you describe this book?
This book is an interactive book for children age 4 to 8, and it's about a family and the senses. All the five senses are in this book in five different sections.
And how is it interactive?
Well, the child reads the book with his parent.
Of course, yes.
And there are missing words in each verse.
Ah.
And he comments on the sights and smells and tastes and touches and what he sees. And then each missing word, he's got to guess by looking at the picture, or she's got to guess by looking at the picture, and then they write it in.
Like
if they're real smart, they can write it in, right in the book, and then check their answer at the back of each section.
And give us an example here of a sentence.
For example, it's silly to my eye, said Timmy to Sister Sue, makeup on your, something's missing, looks ridiculous on you, and the missing word is face.
Okay, and we've got even a couple of letters that the book throws in, right?
Yes,
So you have to fill in F and E, so you have to fill in the rest of it. It's a lovely book, lots of colors and great stories, and I want to know why you wrote it.
I've always been inspired by poetry, so another book I had published was poetry as well. And I wrote it because I think kids, the world of wonders really opens up to them through their five senses. And as a teacher, I wanted to incorporate the five senses in a very fun, exciting, interesting way, and yet have an educational slant as well.
So how'd you come up with this concept?
Sitting outside my cottage, totally quiet, I realized how noisy the city is, so I went and wrote a verse, five verses in fact, about how loud it is in my ear when I'm in the city, and that actually formed the second part of the book called It's Loud in Your Ear.
And it's amazing because kids do really love poetry. I mean, even I've never studied poetry, but I find if I read my daughter poems, even though I stop because I think this must be too old for her, this must be boring, she says, Mommy, keep reading. No, even if she can't understand it, it's the rhythm of the words. They love it.
So true. If you watch a kid at any little concert, They're thumping away their feet, they're moving their hands, and music, our English really does have a beautiful rhythm and feel to it, and I think kids should be introduced to that at a very young age.
One thing that's interesting is this book is, you can get it in French or in English, and Guérin, your publisher, says it's the first time it's ever published anyone in both languages, so your publisher is very proud of you.
Mm-hmm.
But how tough was it to get it published in both languages, to get somebody to listen to you?
I was somewhat surprised because when I presented it, I had done some verses, I translated myself into French, keeping the rhyme, and I thought that, well, if I'm lucky, maybe they'll go for the French, and then I got a call saying they'd really like to go for both versions. So it just all fell into place so
easily. And how do you use it if you want to teach your children? I mean, do you just buy the French book if you're an English family, and the English book if you're a French family, or do you stick with your own language? What would you suggest to the family?
It really depends on the family, but those who really want their kids to learn both languages, this book is ideal because you've got both sort of adaptations right there with the same pictures, and for schools as well, I guess they really like that idea that, you know, they can juggle the languages back and forth.
Now, you're doing a book signing of chapters. When is November 14th?
That's right.
So people can they buy the chapters all the time if they want?
All the time it's there. And actually on November 14th, which I think is Santa Claus Parade Day, I'm also doing some drama with the kids related to the five senses. So that's at 2 and 4.
Okay, that's a great idea. And is it available in other places or is it just at chapters?
Yes,
or?
It is. It's on the Green Avenue store, the Double Hook book.
Uh-huh.
And it's also at another chapter store. The Art Gallery actually carries them. And a few other stores, West Island, Renaud-Bray, and a lot of French stores in Guérin, of course, which is on Saint-Denis Street.
And are you going to write other books? Or is
My mind never stops.
Okay, well, Nancy Snipper, best of luck, and thanks for coming in today.
It was a pleasure.
Bye-bye. That was a conversation I had earlier today with Nancy Snipper, author of the Crazy and Amazing Five Senses book. You can see that book if you go to Chapters on November 14th, and you now have a chance to win a copy of it. We have a French copy and an English copy. We'll give them to our 7th and 8th callers. In the Montreal area, that number is 790-3222. If you're calling from a long distance, it's 1-800-363-1632. 790-3222 or 1-800-363-1632. 16:32, and they go to our seventh and eighth callers.